radio.uccs.edu.
I wish there was a place where I could get all my UCCS athletic information, game previews, game results. I wish there was a place where I could get interviews with players and coaches.
There is, and it's called the Lion's Den, and it's found exclusively on UCCS Radio. So join hosts MJ and Martin every Tuesday at 10 on the Lion's Den, the official source for UCCS sports.
Hello, I'm Pam Shockley-Zalabat, and you are tuned into the Lion's Den, the official source for UCCS sports.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, welcome in. You're tuned in to the Lion's Den, the official source for UCCS sports. I'm the sports MC, MJ Arjamandi, broadcasting live on the University of Colorado, Colorado Springs campus. And I am joined, as always, by my partner in crime, Amber, the Magnificent McAfee. Amber, Miss Magnificent, how you be?
I'm doing good.
Good? How good?
So good, because so good. I'm on the Lion's Den.
Oh!
Which, I mean, you can't get any better than that on Mondays or Tuesdays, so.
Yeah, you're right.
There you go.
So for the millions and millions of listening Lions, get ready, because we're stepping the game up. We got guests, and they are also magnificent.
Yes.
Easy for me to say. I feel bad last week, Amber. I called you malicious, and you were so not malicious. That was such
it kind of reminded me of the Disney character. They're coming out a movie about Sleeping Beauty.
So, yeah.
And they actually called it the malicious something. I can't remember her name.
I saw that recently. You were so not malicious, though. So I felt bad. So, but you are magnificent, though. That's one thing.
Thanks.
So that's much more fitting. Yeah. So, Amber, how was your weekend?
It was decent.
Decent weekend.
Yeah, I spent it mostly working.
Working at B2 Dubs?
Yeah. Come visit me at the World Arena one, guys. But
World Arena.
Yeah.
Okay.
I worked for like 45 minutes on Sunday, though, so I mean, that wasn't too bad. Mm. They sent me home early. No one was coming in.
Well, that's not very good, though, for the bill payings and the budgetings. And
kind of rough, but it was nice because I got to go home and sleep and then watch the Winter Olympics afterwards.
Ooh.
So.
There you go.
Get some homework done, which I needed to do, so it wasn't too bad. It wasn't all a loss.
So at the World Arena, at the Buffalo Wild Wings by there, do you ever get any of the performers after they go to the World Arena? Do they ever stop in and go eat some Wild Wings?
What they do is they send over like a personnel person that will take down all their food, and then they'll hand it to us so that we can put in the order for them. But they never actually come in. The hockey teams might sometimes, but that's about it.
Gotcha.
Yeah, it's like the performers.
Name.
Know. Yeah, like performers, they don't do it.
That is weak sauce, and I'm not talking about the Wild Wing sauce. Weak sauce, dude. That is bummer. Okay, so you worked for 45 minutes, which left a lot of time open for you. What else did you do, Amber?
Watch the Olympics.
The Olympics,
I seriously sat in front of my TV for most of the day watching the Olympics.
The Olympics and homework.
Yeah.
Okay.
I love the Olympics. It's like the only time I'll post 1,000 posts on Facebook or Twitter or something, just because it's the Olympics, and they only do it every 4 years.
Gotcha.
Can't wait for the Summer Olympics. That's my favorite one.
Yeah.
But.
Well, yeah, because you're a runner.
Yeah.
So that's when the running happens.
Yeah, exactly.
Right now, they're on their way.
Yes.
Usain Bolt is running his way right now to the Olympics of 2016.
He's supposed to retire after this
one
upcoming Summer Olympics, so.
Are you a big Bolt fan?
I'm not.
No, why not?
I don't know. He just. It bugs the heck out of me that he slows down before the finish line. And I'm like, you're losing so much more time. Because I'm like, he's too busy celebrating before he actually finishes. And I'm like, you can have such a better time if you just stop celebrating before the finish line.
But what does it matter? A win is a win, right? He's still coming in first.
His teammate, I can't remember his name right now, but his teammate is really close to like coming up and beating him. I'm like, you got to stop doing that because that's how you're going to lose. They're coming for him. So, I got to say on
that. Okay, so you watched some of the Winter Olympics, though.
Did.
We have some athletes in the Olympics that attend UCCS.
We do.
Rumor has it, anyways.
Yes.
So, there's a figure skater that's pretty good.
Yeah.
You said you watched him last night?
I did. He was filling in for the new event that they have, the team figure skating. He took the place of Jeremy Abbott. His name was Jason Brown, and he did pretty good. He had a little mishap where he fell, but felt like all the skaters were falling yesterday, except for the ones who were from Russia, who had the home field advantage practicing on the field beforehand. So, I mean, it's not much you can do about that. But I guess in the individual round, they'll be prepared for it because they got that pre-team skate going.
Gotcha.
So, that's good.
So did you ever have classes with this kid?
No.
That'd be cool, huh?
That would be cool.
We should try to get him on the Lions then.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
I'm on it.
We should make moves.
Let's do it. I'm on it.
You're on
I'm
going
to try to get it.
Amber's got it on lock.
I'm going to try. We'll see.
All right. But we do have some good guests today joining us on the Lions Den. We have a pair of basketball players that absolutely went off this past Saturday night at the Downtown Classic, second annual Downtown Classic at the City Auditorium. That was a hit. You wouldn't know, Amber, because you were working. Where are your priorities?
I know. It was a sad day for me. I was all excited, and then I get a call, and they're like, you got to come in to work. And I was like, no, I don't want to. I was like, I want to go see the game. Transformation of the City Auditorium was really cool. I was like, they have the stage set up all nice. I just wanted to go watch.
It was so fun.
Big arena for an actual game, and I missed out on it.
It was cool.
So,
but doesn't it feel good to be needed? You were needed at B2 Dubs.
It's always
good to feel needed.
I was sneaking on the side of my phone to keep up with the stats on the game, so... That's what I do at B2.
So for all of those of you at B2 Dubs right now, you know what Amber be doing when she be on the clock during UCCS basketball season.
Yes.
Yeah. So your best bet is just to not schedule her and let her come to the games. So if you're listening, managers of Buffalo Wild Wings, which everybody is.
Yes.
Yeah. Know that. So yeah. But you did miss out on an event. I can't lie to you, Amber. It was quite the happening. There was quite a few people there. It was on TV.
I know.
It was on Channel 20 UCCS local Comcast.
First time I ever seen a basketball team game premiered on that channel. So just saying.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was fun.
It was the first time.
It was fun.
Yeah.
It was exciting. And guess who had the call?
Who?
Uh-huh.
Did you get to call?
This guy. Oh, this guy. The play-by-play. It was so much fun. That was seriously one of the most fun nights I've ever had working. They paid me for it, and I couldn't believe it. Everybody's there for free, and I'm getting paid. I'm like, I almost feel bad taking money for that because it was so much fun. I enjoyed working those games. Started off with the women's game and then the men's game, and both were a success. We're going to get you all the recaps for those games during today's broadcast, but just know that was quite the event. What a huge success. It went off without a hitch. It was such a great event. Unlike the Olympics and the opening ceremony when one of the stars didn't quite match up. Did you see that?
Epic fail.
Epic fail. You know, in Russia, they showed video from the rehearsal when it worked. So the Russians didn't even know that it didn't work. They deceived their own people. Which made me think, how often does our government do that to us?
Probably a lot.
Yeah, let's not go getting into that. That's a whole conspiracy theory show we can have. But yeah, I thought that was
good. When it worked during rehearsal.
Yeah, it looked beautiful.
Kind of bummer that we couldn't see it. It was just kind of.
Yeah. We missed there. Out.
Yeah, I was like, we missed out. There's a lot of shirts going around with, like, the four Olympic rings and, like, a little plus sign.
Oh, really?
To represent, like, the fifth ring. I'm like, yes.
Oh, poor little so fifth ring. Couldn't find it. No. It's so cute. He got left out. That's funny. But yeah, the City Auditorium Downtown Classic. What a night. What a night. I could get used to this.
I missed it. I don't even know.
Well, we're going to have videos on YouTube, so you can check out the video. And
that's what I'm doing my weekend.
This weekend?
Yeah, so I'm pretty much catching up.
Perfect.
Especially tomorrow, probably, because I have nothing to do tomorrow. So,
catch up on the games.
Exactly.
But you know what? We got Derrick White and we got Alex Welsh coming in right now, right when we get back from break. They're going to tell you everything you need to know about the game. So,
Sweet.
I mean, you might not even need to watch anything. But, yeah, so that's what's happening today. We're going to talk City Auditorium. Huge game. I can't emphasize that enough. So, we have the stars of the game. I mean, the whole team showed up. But one guy got a double-double. One guy had the single most points ever in a conference game for UCCS men's basketball player.
Crazy.
It was ridiculous.
It was, yeah.
So they are on the show. What a coup.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we're getting them on the show. We're going to talk about the women's game, too, because the women had a great performance as well. They felt the Lions' Den bump of Corey Laster coming on the show, head coach. He was on Thursday, as you know. And they won. So the bump in full effect.
From here on out.
Believe in the bump, I'm saying. Right. We also had softball beginning their opening weekend in Las Vegas, Nevada. They had some fun, but they got some work done at the same time. So we're going to talk about that. Track goes to New Mexico, yeah, right? Amber, our resident expert. She's going to get you all the information you need to know about the track and field team as well. And we got guests for next week's show already lined up. I am super excited about that. But even more importantly, I'm excited about the guests we have coming on right now. So, Amber, without further ado, let's get to break so we can get done with break, so we can get them in here, so we can talk to Derrick White and Alex Welsh of the UCCS men's basketball team. That's exactly what we're going to do when we come back from break. So don't go anywhere, folks. We'll be back with more Lions Den right after this. I'm like, oh, well, they won. So, yeah, I'm a fan now. Look.
Here comes the.
Y'all don't really want it like that. Yeah.
Here comes the.
Ooh.
Here comes the.
Ooh.
Here comes the.
Y'all don't really want it like that.
So I keep big bills up in my heart on the dirty like blood. So ain't got no twist in my head, but I'm still dreadful. And I got plenty of bread, so I go to bed full. I'm in it to win it, I'm all in. I might call you my cuz, young blood, but we ain't kin. You think of jumping, man, you best think again. The dirty, I'm the type of man that might go broke for revenge. Has some not so nice friends, kick the door off the hinge. Take the door off your bins, pop up my four of your friends, man.
Once again, you're tuned in to the Lions Den, the official source for UCCS Sports. Miss Magnificent Amber McAfee, what makes us the official source for UCCS Sports?
We got the inside scoop on all the happenings with UCCS Sports, including interviews with the athletes.
Interviews with athletes?
Yeah.
Like Derrick White and Alex Welsh of the UCCS men's basketball team?
Exactly.
Oh, okay. Yeah, like those guys. Guys, that's you. What's up, fellas? Thanks for joining us today on the Lions Den. How's your day going?
It's good. Thanks for having us. It's always a pleasure to be here.
Yeah, you guys were on last year. That was fun.
Yeah, lots of fun.
Did we play a game last year?
Yeah.
Who won?
I won.
Derrick won. Alex says he won. Okay, well, the competition will ensue today because we're going to have another game a little bit later, just so you know. But for now, business before pleasure. We got to talk some stuff, guys. Big game on Saturday night. If you recall, you guys won. Yeah, you beat Pueblo. Remember those guys? CSU?
Yep.
The rival?
Yep, remember.
Yeah. Okay. So what went down on Saturday night. Tell the millions and millions of listening Lions out there, huge game, right? You guys were tied for third place in the Rocky Mountain Athletic Conference. Pueblo not too far behind. They're a good team. When you guys met on January 4th, you won, but it was a close game. But then you went to the city auditorium, and things went down. What went down? Tell the millions and millions. What happened on Saturday night?
Well, we had a long night Friday night. We were setting the baskets up till about midnight. We got some shots up on them, and then we came back Saturday ready to work, and my man over here, Derrick, decided to score 38 smooth points on him. That kind of led us to the victory. There were a couple technicals in the game. It was a very exciting game. The crowd was out. We were always thankful for them. We just played our game that we've been playing all year, and luckily got out of there with a dub. It got a little close there for a minute, but we went on a run late in the game and eventually came out with a 9-point win.
Yeah. So things are a little bit different this year than last year. I know you both can recall a few really close games that the Mountain Lions were not quite able to pull out. Doesn't seem like that's the way things are going this year. Because you mentioned you got into some trouble, but you guys closed it out. I feel like 38 points, you know, anybody could do that though. Right, Derrick?
Yeah, I guess.
Okay, so watching the game, I feel like what really set the tone, you had a really monstrous dunk in that game. Do you recall this dunk?
Yeah, my man here missed it perfectly off the rim.
Okay, so it really wasn't a miss. It was an assist,
right?
Yeah. You saw Derrick coming. You're like, I'm going to miss strategically off the rim. Derek's going to go about 10 feet high, look like LeBron James for a moment. Stuff at home. Derrick, you had a little wince when you got up, though. Everything all right?
I was fine. I was just really happy and excited to get that dunk.
I felt like there was a collective sigh in the entire city auditorium, like, oh, he's hurt. And then you got up, you sat on the bench for like, I don't know, a minute or so. And then what went on in your mind? Because I feel like you came out and you decided, it's time for me to take this game over. And then you did. Did that thought process go on at all in your head?
Well, I looked at the score and we were down 7 points, and I knew that we needed to make a run soon or else this game could get out of hand. So I just tried to do whatever I could to make that run for us.
38 points. Are you kidding me, dude? Are you kidding me? That is so LeBron-like. That is so Kevin Durant-like. That is ridiculous. So what were you thinking about? I mean, you had a really good game too, Alex. You had a double-double in the game, so you had a really solid performance as well, but what's going on in your mind when you see this kid put up almost 40 points?
Shoot, I was just trying to get him the ball. Honestly, whenever I caught the ball, the first thing I was looking for was Derrick because everything was falling for him. And it's fun to watch him drive and make layups. I mean, it's funny. I mean, possession after possession, he's making layups. And if you don't give him the ball, then I mean, that's a bad teammate. So I was just feeding him and let him go to work.
He's trying to be a good teammate.
Yep, exactly.
All right, fair enough. Again, that was one of the greatest scoring performances I've ever seen. As a result, you've been named the RMAC Player of the Week. You know that?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, who else would give you a run this week? You only had one game, and you scored more points than everybody else in the RMAC. That's ridiculous, right? The game plan, I talked to the head coach before the game. He said, we got to shut down Kobe. I'm pretty sure he meant you. So the game plan had to be to shut you down. You still put up 38 points. I don't get it, dude. I really don't get it. Amber, you missed out on a game there.
No.
Kind of missed out.
Not my fault.
So you had a dunk, and rumor has it you're keeping tabs of dunks. Yeah, Mr. Welsh, we kind of got to talk about this. The millions and millions of listening Lions are curious about this internal dunk competition that is going on right now within the team, and it's obviously working because this is the best season in quite some time. So it's all because of the contest that's happening. But so before the season started, right, you had some kind of wager or would you mind telling the millions?
Well, just let them know.
Yeah, what's happening with that? Well, first, what's the deal with this dunk competition? Who's winning and what are the stipulations?
Well, the dunk contest is it has to be a clean dunk.
So like the one he had?
Yes,
on...
that was a very clean dunk.
Yeah.
We're just the main three they're keeping track right now. It's Dalton, Derrick, and myself. Dalton's in the lead with, I believe,
16,
17, something like that. Derrick's in second with
11.
11, and I am struggling. I'm struggling with five.
Five dunks.
I'm in a dry spell. I haven't got a dunk since we played at Pueblo.
Ooh, so it's been like, a minute.
It's been like 8 weeks since I've got a dunk. But you know what? I take victories over dunks anytime. But, you know, it's just this fun little thing. You know, we all talk a little smack to each other about dunking in games and stuff. And Derrick decided it'd be cute if I shave my legs if he beats me. And right now it's looking like I got to shave my legs at the end of the season.
Oh,
so.
No.
So, yeah, I'm a little upset about it, but hopefully
it's not over.
It's not over. It's not over.
Still plenty of time to make a run.
Yeah, but Derrick has decided that he wants to dunk about every game. So I got to get a lot of dunks to catch up. But, you know, if I shave my legs, I'm hoping it'll grow back. And that's the sad truth.
Okay, so what does the winner get? Nothing?
We just get the laugh.
Just want to not lose?
Yeah.
Okay, basically. Fair enough. Well, if it makes you feel better, you have more dunks than I do. You're beating me.
Thanks. I'm beating maybe a couple guys on the team, but hey, it's all right.
But still third. Again, so maybe not the dunks, but a double-double this past weekend. That's pretty solid. Called you the double-double machine last year, and it really seems like any game you're capable of getting that double-double.
Yeah, it's been my focus this year is to rebound, and I mean, the points come and go, but you know, I always try to focus on rebounding because it's always there for me, and I've had a couple games this year with 9 rebounds. I mean, stats aren't that big of a deal, like I said, when we're getting victories, but it's always nice when the coaches give me crap for only getting 9 rebounds. But, just
and
rebounding.
No dunks.
Yeah, no dunks. No but, dunks. You know, crashing the boards is something I can always do, so I always fall back on it when my shot's not falling or other things like that. I can always rebound.
You know, I talked to head coach Jeff Culver before the game on Saturday, and I told him, I said, well, we know Derek's going to put up points. That's just what Derrick does. I don't know how, but 38 points, no big deal. I asked him who else really needs to step up here to make sure you guys get the win. And Welsh, your name was brought up. He said, I really need my bigs to step up, Welsh and Patton. And you had a double-double. I think that has to be emphasized because 38 points, obviously, that's pretty awesome. But you're crashing the boards, you're feeding your teammates, you're putting up points at the same time. Seems like you do a little bit of everything. And I've seen you in the gym, at least in the off season, working on your range.
Mm-hmm.
And it looks like you really have been working on developing that shot from beyond the arc. Mm-hmm. I mean, what goes into the off season and trying to make those adjustments and improvements?
Yeah, absolutely. In high school, I shot a lot of threes. You know, I shot a lot more outside in high school than I did in college. And after my freshman year, you know, I just thought, you know, it's going to help my game if I can expand my range. And I'm working with one of my trainers in the off season. He was actually one of my high school coaches, and he ended up going a different route, and he's getting to personal training, basketball training, that is. And he's really been helping me. In the summer, I worked hard every day on just lots of shooting workouts and just getting the reps up. So that's what it comes down to. And, you know, I haven't shot the best this year from deep, but I've shot a lot better than I did last year. And it's just a process. I'm just going to keep working on it and working on it, and hopefully it'll be there within the next couple of years.
And what area of your game, Mr. White, do you want to improve upon? Or are you pretty content with where you're at, 38 points and all that?
No, I want to work on my three-point shooting as well. Like, last game I was 3-for-3, and that's like...
Yeah, how do you improve that? Yeah, I didn't miss one. The Downtown Classic, I went off from downtown, but yeah, I'll get better. How do you get better? More threes?
Yeah, but in the overall season, I'm shooting like 26% or something like that. So
okay.
I want to improve that, and... Well, that will open so much more stuff in my game if I can shoot better.
Gotcha.
I want to know what your pre-game ritual is. Like, what do you do to get in the zone before you go out on the court?
That's a great question.
I don't really do much. I just sit there and relax, try to joke around a little bit. And I don't really get, like, focused until, like, the national anthem. That's usually, like, my focus time, nice and quiet in the gym.
What about you, Alex?
I like to zone out. I like to wear my headphones and kind of sit off to the side because Derek's over here cracking jokes. No, I'm just kidding. No, we all chat pretty much during the girls' game, but once we start getting dressed, I throw the headphones on and try to zone out and, you know, just try to find my zone, try to find my focus and think about what I want to do and just, I don't know, get my body right when we warm up and play hard when the tip.
I see sometimes Darius, Mr. Partner, getting everybody in a circle and kind of going crazy inside the circle. Does that work? Does that hype you guys up? Or is he just kind of going crazy for a moment? I love Darius. He's awesome. But he's really emotional when it comes to the game. He's one of the emotional leaders, I'd venture to say, on the team. I think that's his way of getting everybody hyped up, though, right? Does that work?
I like it. I mean, it's kind of cool watching him dancing there for
doing the Dougie.
10 seconds.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's high energy, so we can always use energy, and that's what he is for us. He comes off the bench with tons of energy, and before the game, he has a high five, handshake with everyone. So, yeah, he's our energy guy for sure.
What has been the biggest difference, would you say, from last year to this year, where, again, going back to earlier, you lost quite a few games at the last minute, last second, last possession. Already, the team has about three times as many wins as it had last season. You had five wins all season long right now. I mean, there's still six games to be decided, and you've already got 15 wins. So what's been the biggest difference between last year and this year?
I think we learned a lot from last year. So last year, we were a young team, and we didn't have much college experience, and so that showed at the late games. But we learned from that, and we work on like being strong on the ball as last year. We watched the CSU Polo game from last season before this game, and it hurt a little bit, but we had to see what we made the mistakes we did last year, and we corrected them this year, and we got the dub.
Mm-hmm. How about the coach, Jeff Culver? Second year, and he's really turned the program around. And so I know both of you are sophomores, so you only know playing for him, but how has he really helped turn around the culture here? A few years ago, this would have been unthinkable to have this kind of a record. You're on the verge of hosting a playoff game. I mean, so what is it that Coach Jeff Culver does to really get the most out of you guys? How do you think he's been able to flip this program like he has?
Yeah, like you said, me and Derrick have only experienced playing college basketball under Culver, but we heard a lot of horror stories from the previous years. And, you know, Coach Culver, he really knows his X's and O's, and he knows the game inside and out better than any coach I've ever played for. So, you know, when he can break down a play or break down a mistake we made and make it simple for us to see on a whiteboard or anything like that, it helps us just improve so much quicker than if he were just to scream at us and make us run sprints. So, I mean, of course we get yelled at and we run sprints and we work hard in the weight room, everything, but he really knows what he's talking about when it comes to defense, offense, whatever it is. He knows his X and O's to a T, and that just helps us a lot.
I think he'd be proud that you said that. He's probably listening.
Yeah,
he does that. I got Darius in trouble last year when he was on the show.
I was with him.
Yeah. We don't talk about those things on the air anymore.
All right. So why did you ever go into basketball? Like, what made you start playing basketball, get you into it?
I'd say my dad. My dad played basketball when he was in high school, and my dad's like this big sports guy. That's all he talks about is sports. So I've been with basketball since I was like 4 years old, so it's just the only thing I really know.
What about you, Mr. Welsh?
Yeah, the same. My dad played high school basketball. He played college basketball. He got me basketball hoop when I was like 4 or 5, and I started shooting around on it, and then I started playing in the rec leagues and stuff like that, and I just loved it ever since, and just played. I played soccer too, but I just really liked basketball a lot more. I like soccer, so I just went with it, played in high school, everything like that, and it just worked out for me.
Yeah, I think you made the right decision.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Me too.
So who do you guys emulate? I'm sure you guys watch the NBA or even college ball. Is there anybody that you really try to, you know, mimic your game like? Or anybody you looked up to growing up? Who was kind of the guy or the girl? Who was that person that you kind of looked to for inspiration growing up watching?
I would say for me, I like
MJ?
No.
Not me.
Oh. Well, of course, the greats like LeBron, Michael Jordan, but a guy who I really appreciate his game is Kevin Love, because he is the double-double king.
Double. Yes. Yeah, that
he
makes
is
sense.
The king of double-doubles. But, no, I just like the way he plays the game. I think that he's very humble, and I like the way – I like his play style. He just works hard, and, I mean, of course, he can score 40 on you, but he does the dirty work, and I like that, and I respect that, and that's kind of what I want to emulate. I'm definitely leaps and leaps and leaps and bounds away from numbers that he's putting up, but, you know, small steps, you know, I got a couple more years to catch up to him. Maybe a big 2020 game or something like that would be nice.
And then the Taco Bell commercials will ensue after that.
Yeah. As soon as I get that 2020 game, the Taco Bell will call me, you know what I'm saying?
It's coming, man.
Free Taco Bell for life.
That's right. That's right. What about you, Derrick? Anybody? For me, if I could take a guess, I don't know who you watch, but you play a lot. I'm sure you've heard this a lot. Like Kevin Durant. The size, the stature, the ability to score at will, the ability to drive with the ball, handling skills, rebounding, all those things. Is that at all close?
Yeah, I get that a lot, but I don't really have a personality that I play like, but I've been watching like LeBron and Durant, and I just want to be like them because they're the best in the game right now. So if I can like be complimented like a play like Durant, that's a compliment to me, and I'm taking it.
Well, I venture to say you're one of the best players in the RMAC, both of you guys amongst the top. I mean, double-double at will, 38 points. Like, it's not. I haven't scored 38 points my entire life. You put it up in one game. Ridiculous.
What are your thoughts of potentially hosting the first game of RMAC tournament here in UCCS history, basically?
That's never happened. You guys know that, right?
Didn't the girls do it last year?
The girls hosted the second ever playoff game in school history, but no men's team has ever hosted a playoff game in basketball. So
the first, making history.
That's right. And right now, looking at the standings again, you're in third place with six games left. Not the easiest of schedules, but not the most difficult either. You have four of the six games here at home. So what are your thoughts on making that run, hosting at home, and kind of what do you guys expect at the end of the regular season? Where do you expect to be?
Well, I just want to start off by saying I was extremely jealous of the girls last year when they were hosting that first round. We were here, we were watching, we were like, man, this could be us. This is awesome. The atmosphere was awesome. So, I mean, that's always fuel to the fire, just remembering what it was like for the girls to host. So we would love to get our chance, and these next couple weeks are huge for us. We've talked all year about a signature win, and this upcoming weekend we have the ability to get two of them. You know, it's a huge opportunity, and we're grateful for the opportunity, but we always say that the next game ahead of us is the most important. So right now we're just focusing on Adams. We got him at their place, and it'd be great for us to get him at our place. And then the next night we have Fort Lewis, and that could be our signature win for the season. So, you know, we're really going to work hard this week and do what we got to do to get that signature win and host that first round, which would be huge for the program, huge for us. And we could rub it in the girl's face that we got one too.
Anything you can do, we can do better. But that means you got to win, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, the girls played really good, but unfortunately they fell short in their playoff game. But you guys could exceed those.
Yeah, absolutely.
Right? What about you, Derrick? What would it mean to you to be able to host a playoff game here this season?
I mean, it'd be huge because we got the local support. We got the fans on our side instead of them yelling at us. Yeah. I mean, we've got our home court, and we want, at the beginning of the year, we didn't want to lose at our home court, and we've already lost two. So if we get another chance at playing at our home court, we feel like we can hold our home court, and it'd be an advantage for us.
Gallagly? That's home? Gallagly Event Center.
Yeah.
And that's where you're going to be on Friday night. You got a date with Adam State.
Yep.
You excited for that?
Yes.
I mean, probably not the most ideal way to spend Valentine's Day, but that's going to be exciting, right?
What could be better than playing basketball on Valentine's Day?
That's true.
Exactly.
How do you think the crowd is going to show up for that night? Do you expect a big crowd or not so much?
You know, we can always want a big crowd, but, you know, I'm sure a lot of people will be taking their girlfriends out, going to dinner and stuff like that, but I'm sure we'll have a few. We have some loyal fans. We got a good group of guys.
Some lonely friends, you know, some single fans.
Some single guys. We could get the big crowd of single guys. No, we have some loyal fans. We got a few guys, maybe 10 or so. They should come to every game, and I'm pretty sure they'll be there. They know it's a big game.
Okay, so we can expect about 10 people in the Gallagly Event Center.
At least. No, I'm just kidding. I think we'll have an okay showing.
Pretty good.
Yeah.
That's good stuff. So right now, again, one of the best records in quite some time, and you're on the verge of having the best record in program history. I mean, what is this season so far? It's not over, but how do you feel about being where you're at right now? Being in this spot in the RMAC with this record, with 38 points, with a double-double, with all these things, how do you guys feel right now? Again, especially considering where you came from last year. How good does this feel?
I mean, it feels great, especially because last year we won 5 games, and it was hard for us to like get used to the losing and all, but we had to take those losses to become where the team we are right now. So I'd say like this season's been up and down. We had like a 4-game winning streak, and then we went on a 3-game losing streak, and now we're back on a 5-game winning streak. So it's up and down, but we're just trying to ride this high and keep it to the playoffs.
Mm-hmm, absolutely. And it's never enough for us because, you know, we love that we've won 15 games? 15. It's 15? Yeah. We won 15 games already, but it's never enough for us because right now those are done. Those already happened, and we're just looking forward to this Friday night and Saturday night. And the big picture here is the playoffs for us because that was something we didn't even have a shot at last year. So this year having a shot is big for us, and we just want to make some noise.
You know, this is the biggest turnaround in program history from 5 wins to 3 times as many wins and counting. So you guys really are a part of history right now. I think that's – I can't say that enough how huge this is. So I think awesome. This is so exciting, and I'm really happy for you guys. Yeah. I got to ask you a question. Derrick, you were on the RMAC radio show last week.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, it's kind of the minor leagues. Now you're here on the Lions, Dan, right? Huh. Stepping your game up. I joke. How do we compare to the RMAC radio show? I've never been on the show, so I wouldn't know. But how do we fare to Mr. Eric Danner and all the great people at the RMAC?
You know, it was fun doing the RMAC show, but you're right here face-to-face with MJ. I mean, it's a great experience here, you know. I'm on a telephone with Eric Danner, but, you know, I'm face-to-face with MJ. You know, right. It's pretty awesome here.
That's right. I'll sign autographs later. You got to give me one, too. Right on, guys. I do want to wish you all the best of luck this weekend. Before we get you out of here, though, we got a game to play.
Alrighty.
Yeah, you guys know you've been here before.
Yeah.
The winner gets a shirt. Check it. We only got one, so you're playing for something. All right, dudes?
Alrighty.
Yeah.
Looks good.
That's sweet, right? UCCS radio. Yeah. So this is legit. I mean, high roll. You didn't get that on the RMAC radio show. See, Eric needs to step
no games.
His game up. See, you're on the Lions, then. We like to have some fun, too. So serious business, though. A great start to the season. A great run so far. It's not over, but let's have a little bit of fun right now. All right, so I got some questions for you. If you want to play along, you can win a shirt.
I'm ready to win this shirt.
Yeah, who won last year?
Well, we weren't on at the same time last year, were we?
Oh.
I think I was on with Alex Kohler and Darius last year.
I was on with Darius.
And I won that one.
Okay. Oh, mine. So you were both right when you said you won. Oh, I thought you guys were just BSing me.
It's a championship here.
Oh, yeah, okay. So that makes sense. A championship. Championship. Okay. So our first question is we're going to do the name that mountain lion.
Okay.
Hopefully you know a few.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So name that mountain lion. Okay. So our first mountain lion is what's going on in Parker? I mean, everybody's from Parker.
It's the basketball hotbed.
I guess.
I mean, talent go to Parker.
I guess. Three starters on the team from Parker. Okay. Well, this in particular starter is from Parker, Colorado. Okay. So there's your first clue. He's a guard. He's a junior. He's from Nebraska Kearney.
Tim Billingsley.
Yeah, Derrick, you got him. You know Tim Billingsley. Why don't you tell the millions and millions of listening Lions what you know about Tim Billingsley?
I know Tim Billingsley can shoot the ball, and he does it really well.
All right, that's all you need to know. That is all you need to know. Point for Mr. White. Perfect. All right. Let's see. Going down the list. So this mountain lion is from Michigan. From Michigan.
Oh, Coach Culver.
Oh, man, my man. He's the only guy from Michigan, huh?
All we hear about is Michigan, okay?
Really?
Michigan sports, Detroit sport. That's all we ever hear about from Coach Culver.
Is he a Lions fan?
Yes, he is.
Is he a Pistons fan?
Yes, he is.
Oh, man, how do we help that? We got to help him.
We just struggle.
Good thing he's here, right? Mountain Lion pride. Yeah. All right, we're all tied up. 1-1. How about that? Very competitive game. All right. Yep. All right, well, let's see. So this individual he's been named as an RMAC player of the week. He's gonna go down as the second leading scorer in a single game in UCCS program history.
It's me.
Who's me?
Derrick White. Give him the point. It's him. He deserves it.
Okay, that is you. You scored 38 points. For those of you who don't know, that's the second most points ever scored in a basketball game here at UCCS. It's the most points ever scored in a conference game. Yeah, you did that, dude. You did that. Okay, so here's our... in case you didn't know, that's you.
Do you know off the top of your head who scored the most in a game?
Bane.
Do you know how many points it was?
45.
Oh, come on, Derrick.
I thought it was 39.
45. Wow. According to the official records, 45.
Points
out. You know what? You know, I got to tell you, too, in case you don't know, you missed a free throw at the end of the game.
I missed 3 free throws, actually.
In the whole game. But at the end, you missed one in particular that I recall, and that would have brought you into second exclusively. Now you're just tied for second.
I know. I messed up.
How do you live with yourself?
I struggled.
I'm just kidding. All right. Okay, so right now, 2-1. Derrick's on top. All right. So you kind of need this point.
Got this.
You got this. All right. So this mountain lion is from Aurora, Colorado. He's a junior guard.
Darius Partner.
And he works at the Center for Excellence in Communication. Darius Partner.
Campbell.
That would not have been correct, sir.
That is Aurora, Colorado.
Minus one. Mm-hmm. Up 2-1.
Aurora. All right.
2-2.
Okay. 2-2. We're all tied up. We're all knotted up here on the Lion's Den. Things are getting interesting. These guys really want that shirt. Battle of the Champs. You wouldn't expect anything else, you know? All right, so this mountain lion is also a previous RMAC player of
Alex Welsh.
The week. Yeah.
Bring it.
He is the only other mountain lion that's been an RMAC player of the week, so by default.
I was like, wait, did Dalton get it?
Was that me? That was you, dude. You didn't even know.
I know. Whoops.
You were an RMAC player of the week. If you don't know, now you know. So, Derrick, you're up 3-2.
It's over.
It's over. Well, it's not over. We still got time. We still got a few more name that mountain lion. So, 3-2 lead. Things are getting interesting. So, this mountain lion is also a former RMAC player of the week. And this former RMAC player of the week is in the top 15 in the nation for scoring and for free throw percent.
Abby Kirkhoff.
I never said it had to be from the guys, team. I never said that. Right. My man, thinking ahead.
What?
Mr. Welsh, that's right.
I'd have known that.
Abby Kirkhoff is in the top 15 in the nation. Did you know that?
Yeah, she's nice.
Yeah, she's
nice.
Pretty good.
Rumor has it she's challenged you to a game or two, Mr. White.
She hasn't challenged me in a game, but we have a competition, like who can score the most points, so I just took the lead with 38. You know, her 35 is way down there.
Weak. Weak. How could she live with herself 35?
We have all these little fun bets because bragging rights are important on the men's and women's team here. It's all about the bragging rights.
What else do we got? What other side bets? Oh, I know the dunk competition. I know the points competition. What else we got going on here?
We got a 45 competition after practice.
Yeah, we play this game. It's called 45, and we have some vicious battles in there. Even the coaches jump in. Coach Snyder and Coach Elicate play with us.
Really?
And it gets intense. I'll have to let you know. You have to come peep it behind the scenes.
Yeah, what happens? So what goes down?
It's a game. It's a three-point shooting game, and the goal is to get to 45 first. So a team will shoot threes first, and if they miss, you have a chance to – you and your partner, the other team – have a chance to tip it in, and that's 1 point, and a made three is 2 points. And each person has to miss two, or has to make four out of five threes to keep going around. So if you make three out of five, you switch the team switch, and it's the first one to 45, and it just gets intense.
Can we get in on this?
Yeah.
I used to be a runner-up in basketball.
Yeah. Alex Kohler wins every time.
Come on in.
Yeah, the three-point crippler.
Challenge Kohler.
We play after practice. If you guys want to come get some, just let us know.
I don't want any. I want none. They call me MJ, but I dance more like Michael Jackson than ball like Michael Jordan.
I respect it.
The moves.
Just saying. Okay, so we're tied 3-3.
Let's go.
Okay, so we got one more question, and this is going to be the end-all, be-all.
Okay.
Whoever gets this gets the shirt.
Okay.
So, I mean, be ready. All right, so this mountain lion has been at UCCS for approximately 10 years. That's right, 10 years. He was a coach in the Rocky Mountain Athletic Conference. Steve Kirkham, the athletic director. He was a coach for 16 years at Colorado Mesa in Grand Junction. He's been a mountain lion for 10 years here at UCCS. So Kirkham is
veteran.
The veteran. Yeah. Yeah. I'm sorry, Mr. White, but you can't win everything.
This is ridiculous.
Throwing some curveballs, right? Got the AD in there. Got Abby Kirkhoff in there.
I was thinking like Snyder or something, but...
You know what? This is a true story, too. You know Alex used to play here? Yeah. Snyder?
Yeah.
That's how long I've been here. I worked here when he played here. Do you know that? True story. I saw him play in the Lion's Den.
Oh, wow.
In Burger Hall. You guys know Burger Hall?
Yeah.
Yes.
I've seen some
came
pictures.
Came a long way.
Yeah. Isn't that a cute little gym?
I don't know if that's the right word for it, but
yeah, so that's how long I've been here. But we do have a winner. I'm sorry, Mr. White. You can have your RMAC Player of the Week honors. You can have your RMAC radio show. You can have your 38 points. But Mr. Welsh,
I get the t-shirt. I get the t-shirt.
Oh, man. But, thanks, you know, MJ. Everybody comes away with something on Lions Den. So here's a bottle opener for all of your sodas that you drink because, you know, you're in college, you're an athlete, you don't drink alcoholic beverages, I'm sure. So you won't need it for that, but you'll need it for whatever else that you get into. So there you go. There's the Lions Den. There's the game. Mr. Welsh, congratulations, sir.
Thank you.
Mr. White, you put up quite the fight, just like the other night. But you can't put up 38 points and expect to win here on the Lions Den. Yeah. So that's the way it works. But thank you guys for stopping by today. And big game again this Friday night against Adams State. That's how you're spending Valentine's Day. So hopefully it, you know, ends the way you want it to with a big W. And then Fort Lewis on Saturday night. So you guys are on a roll. Double-double machine, 38 points. That's huge. Congratulations for the City Auditorium. That was exciting stuff, guys.
Thank you. Thanks for having us. Always fun.
Yeah, thanks for stopping by here on the Lions Den. And we're going to be back with more recap from Saturday night and much, much more here on the Lions Den. So don't go anywhere. We'll be back right after this.
The 2014 Ram 1500. First ever back-to-back winner of the coveted Motor Trend Truck of the Year. Available today with $7,700 total savings at your Ram dealer.
Tuned in to the Lions Den, the official source for UCCS sports. A huge thank you to Derrick White and Alex Welsh of the UCCS men's basketball team for stopping by. Hopefully they had a little bit of fun. Mr. Welsh got himself a new shirt.
Champion.
Champion
of
the
name athlete.
That's right.
I know. He picked it too, so ironically he must have knew he was going to win today.
He knew. I think he knew. He just knew. Yeah, that's ridiculous. But yeah, excellent job from those guys this weekend. And also, Amber, for the women's team.
Yeah.
That's a huge win.
They came back with a vengeance.
They did.
They did.
They lost to Pueblo on January 4th by 1 point.
1 point.
They were up by 8 points with less than 5.5 minutes remaining. And they didn't quite pull it out. But this weekend, much different. The women's team pulled out what I consider to be the biggest win of the season to this point.
Yeah.
Pueblo had only lost twice in conference play all season long, Amber.
That's crazy.
That is crazy. You know, I hate to toot my own horn here, Amber, and your own horn and Kelsey's horn. But, you know, we have something in here that we believe in with a passion.
Yes.
We believe it. And the proof is in the pudding, and it's called the Lions Den Bump.
Yes.
When you come on the show, and we probably should have told Alex and Derrick, but as good as they're playing, I don't – that would be scary to think they're going to get better.
I'm sure their teammates will pass it on.
They'll pass it on,
yeah. They know.
But the Lions Den Bump. When you come on the show, you see an instant improvement in your game and in the results. This was the first time that a women's basketball player or coach was on the show all season long.
Yes.
Last Thursday, head coach Corey Lassiter on the show, and he felt the bump. The Mountain Lions won. The women won. I will take the assist, as will you, as will Kelsey. We'll take the assist on the Lions Den because the women did win, and they won in convincing fashion, 84-75. That was the men's score, 67-57, the 10-point win for the women. that was a huge win, though, because it got them right on pace where they need to be to make the playoffs now.
Yes.
Big win. Huge win. Huge win. And so that really, I think, is the catalyst of the season right now. It's going to turn everything around, Amber.
And it all started with the Lions Den.
It all started with the Lions Den. That's right. So we'll take some credit there. That was excellent. So
yes.
Some more games on the horizon. They got the same Adam State date on Valentine's Day. Do the women this Friday. And Amber, where can the millions and millions catch the preview for that?
They can catch it on the Lions Den Thursday at 10.
Oh, yeah. All right. That's right. So we'll be catchy. Here. That's right. So, I love saying that. So, yeah, check out the expansion show on Thursday at 10. And Kelsey and I will give you all the preview for that game and much, much more. But we had another weekend of action for another sport. And that was softball, as they got things rolling this season, this weekend.
Weather permitted.
No, Las Vegas didn't snow, so they were able to get the games in. And they started off really well, Amber. They took on Northwest Nazarene, and they won 4-3. They went into the final inning trailing, and they had to put up 3 runs in the final inning to win that game.
Great.
Yeah, and that was great. So they started off with a W, so they were 1-0, undefeated for a moment. But unfortunately for them, they played some of the top Division II teams in all of the nation.
Yeah.
All of the nation. Yeah. And so they continued in the Desert Stinger Classic later that day against Central Washington, and it wasn't quite as favorable. That was on MJ Day, I might add, on my birthday.
Yeah, your birthday.
Yeah, so that was cool. But some really talented freshmen already, as Nikki Hoffman and Sammy Meyer hit their first collegiate home runs of their careers. And just based on what they did this weekend, those two are going to be great. They have a lot to look forward to, and so do the fans here at UCCS. A lot of freshmen on the softball team, but good freshmen.
Yeah.
Freshmen that are coming in and already having an impact.
It's impressive. Not going to lie, it's impressive.
Right, as an athlete.
And then they'll
yourself,
be here for like the next 4 years, so we're just only going to keep getting better.
Right.
With the freshman team, so.
Yeah.
So it's a good thing.
That is a good thing. That's the future right there. And so I think that that's going to be excellent to see them kind of evolve. And they're already contributing to the team. And so that really is good to see. And then we have a pitcher that head coach Scott Peterson has raved about, Stephanie Chudkowski. She recorded 5 strikeouts in her debut.
Yeah.
I mean, that is impressive. Absolutely.
That's amazing.
She had a really good weekend, to be honest with you, not just in that game, but all the way around. The Mountain Lions back in action after splitting the first day against Dixie State. Dixie State in the top 20, nationally speaking. They're 23rd in the nation. And the Mountain Lions, they didn't quite win that one.
Yeah.
They fell a little bit short in that game against the Red Storm, but that was close. 7-5. They put up quite the fight. Again, they found themselves trailing in the final inning, and they tried to make a run, but they just couldn't quite do it. That's a tough team.
Yeah, I was like, but they came back.
They did.
They came back later that day.
They did.
With intensity, because they came back and won against Augustana. So,
who is ranked 22nd in the nation, I might add. So the Mountain Lions did beat a nationally ranked team this weekend. That bodes really well for their abilities this season. They took the 22nd team in all the nation, and they beat them 4-3. I mean, so anytime you could beat a nationally ranked team, that's making a very, very big point.
Yeah.
And so they're there. They got the talent. Clearly the talent is there. So they split the first 2 days. They went 1-1 each day.
Right.
Unfortunately for the Mountain Lions, they had to play the 8th ranked team in the nation the next day. And they were shut out in that game. They did have runners in scoring position a few times, but were just unable to capitalize. But a bright spot of that game, Amber, they only allowed 4 runs.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's not that bad. And you have to give them the benefit of the doubt. Because, I mean, they played 5 games over the weekend.
Yeah.
And they had to travel to Las Vegas to go play them. So they were probably really tired by the time that game rolled around. So you have to give them the benefit of the doubt
in
the last one. So.
Right. And they went 1-2 against nationally ranked teams.
Yes.
I mean, of course, you want to go 2-1. You want to go 3-0. But at the least, you want to win a game against a nationally ranked team. And they did. And they were in every game. It's not like they were blown out ever.
No.
You know, a 4-0 loss, that was their that was a shutout, and they did lose, you know, one of those other games by a little bit more. But, you know, overall, I think that was a really good showing. Scott Peterson knew that was really tough competition, but they're going to be back in action, not this weekend, but the following weekend, so plenty of time to preview for the start of conference season when the softball team will head to Chatterton, Nebraska to take on Chatterton State and Colorado Mines, so they'll be there. But Amber, what about track and field? What went down with track? You know, it's really hard to preview some of the stuff on Thursday when, you know, it's really kept kind of a secret as to who's competing. So we didn't preview
too
much.
We don't even know too much.
You don't even know, and you're in the loop. But what happened?
We know now. So,
we do know now.
Yeah, it's like we know
now. Hindsight's always 20/20, right?
Yeah.
So what happened then with your track and field?
They actually had a really good weekend. They sent 4 guys and 3 girls to New Mexico. Our men's 4x4 smashed the UCCS indoor record for that by 2 seconds, and they provisionally qualified. So hopefully if no one else beats their time, they're going to nationals. That would be great. John Wright just barely missed provisionally qualifying in the 400 by 1/100 of a second, which is always rough.
Ouch.
Like, that's the hardest loss you can lose by.
Yeah.
And then Alexa Urban also provisionally qualified in the 800 meter.
Watch out!
So... And on top of that, UC track meets are a little different. Division 1 can compete against Division 2 in some of the meets. Yeah, but Alexa had beat 11 of those competitors and got 5th overall. So
she might be recruited somewhere for D1.
Who knows, maybe. I was like, who knows, maybe. Then Mel and McKenzie, they were the other 2 girls that went, and they ran the 1600, and they got a personal best in it. Both of them PR'd.
Nice.
Yeah, so it was a good weekend for the track team. They all did what they wanted to do, went out there and got it done.
Yeah.
And hopefully we'll get it done again this week.
Get it done this week.
Yeah, like, get it done this week.
And hopefully we'll have something to preview.
Yes.
On the preview show, Thursday at 10.
Yes.
So now, Amber, is the time we got to do the what to watch for.
Right.
So tell the millions and millions and millions of listening Lions out there, what to watch for.
Watch out for all the happenings that are going to be on the Lions Den Thursday at 10 with your new host, Kelsey, and MJ will be there.
That's right.
So,
that's exactly right.
So, and I'll be listening too. So you guys, tune in.
Tune in Thursdays at 10 to the Lions Den for the extension show, the expansion show, the preview show, whatever you want to call it. We're going to preview everything that's coming up for the entire weekend. And there's a lot of stuff going down. So you don't want to miss
it. You'll be refreshed on when everything is because it's right the day before all the weekend happens.
That's right.
So
it's
can't
perfect.
Miss it. It's a good time.
We did that for a reason.
Yes.
That is right. So in the meantime, be sure to like us on Facebook at the Lions Den UCCS. Follow us on Twitter at the Lions Den UCCS. And follow us, stalk us, like us in real life. Do all those things. I don't know about Amber, but I love when people stalk me, like me, and follow me. So do all that stuff. And of course, until next time, Amber, go Mountain Lions!